Jamie Altman here, pastor of Bethlehem Community Church. We want to thank you so much for tuning in today in our services. It's our vision here at Bethlehem to spread the gospel using every avenue possible. But we also have a deep conviction to let you know that these services, this streaming service that we offer, is not in any way to replace the importance of being involved in a local church and being under the direction of a local pastor. And if you don't have a local church, we invite you to come and be a part of us at your earliest convenience. But for now, we hope that you enjoy this service, and may the Lord bless you today. More exciting things that we do here for our kids, and so we're thankful that you have chosen to join us. And the kids will be coming and performing here momentarily. But a few housekeeping things we're going to take care of. We're going to go ahead and get our offering out of the way. I know some of you have in mind about giving to the boys or girls. We'll explain all that. To hold all that for now, this offering will just be for our church people, our regular tithes and offerings for today, as our ushers will come forward during this time. We had a tremendous week at Bible study, or Bible school rather. Had kids getting saved, all kinds of things happening, and we'll share those things with you momentarily. But appreciate you for being here, and those of you that are giving today, we appreciate that. There's no way we could do what we've just done throughout this past week. It takes an army, and it takes dedicated givers to accomplish what has happened this past week. And so for that, we say thank you. And whatever you decide to give today, we say thank you for that. All right. Let's go to the Lord in prayer at this time. Brandon, pray for us.
Lord, I just want to thank you for everyone that's here today. Thank you for the amazing week at Bible school. Thank you for the leaders. Thank you for all the kids. I just pray that your will be done today, and I just pray that you'll bless us all, bring into your service. In Jesus' name, amen.
All right. Well, they are almost set. As you can see, we had a boatload of kids this past week, 244 registered. It says 136 volunteers we had throughout the week. And you say, aren't you excited about all the kids? Hey, we love kids here at Bethlehem Community Church. But listen to me. I'm just as proud of 136 volunteers. Hey, there's no way we could do what we've done this week without all the people stepping up and serving. There are so many different things. We try to do our Vacation Bible School first class, and it takes a lot of help. It takes an army of people who are dedicated and willing to serve in all kinds of different areas. And so if you have served in any capacity throughout this week, would you stand for me? If you've served in any way, kitchen, volunteers, helping, everybody, of course, all of them standing. Hey, give them a round of applause. Yes. So thankful for all of our volunteers. Appreciate you. Words just can't express how much we appreciate you. Okay. A little over 300 in attendance every night of VBS. And 12 kids gave their life to the Lord. Amen? Yes. Well, words can't express everything. But we do have a little video that kind of incorporates everything that happened this week. Let's show that now.
Church hat clap, man, it shook every color purple coming back clap. When that whole week beat you up and stretch you, but you hear that organ playing and remind you of your blessings. And on another note, she just hit another note. Chills down my spine, got me crying, make me overload. You don't know about it though. Old school church hymns, deacons get the humming out of drama. Fit the fuck. Keep it.
from Vacation Bible School.
Dear Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for everything you have done. Thank you for us being able to come to VBS.
Thank you, God, for letting us all be here. I hope you love us and you keep us safe for all times.
Thank you for me. Thank you for everybody else.
Thank you, Lord, for VBS and our church. And let all these children learn about you.
We will respect you and you will keep us away from the devil. If we have sin in our hearts, you will tell us to do good things to take the sin out of our hearts.
God, thank you for church, and thank you for letting us learn about you. And thank you for mom and dad's, and I really appreciate it. Amen.
Dear Lord, thank you for the day. Thank you for allowing us all to be here. Lord, thank you for allowing all of us to be here to worship you. A lot of us don't come to church, and please let them experience you.
Dear Lord, thank you for the day.
Dear Lord, thank you for bringing everybody and making new friends and seeing new people and trying to invite them to here, to the church. And thank you for letting us have a good day. Please continue to speak to us.
I like for Jesus to be here so that you love me and I love you, then you will come to me, Jesus. Amen.
Every year, one of the fun things we do is we have this battle between the boys and the girls in offering. Of course, as you know, it takes resources, takes a lot of funding to do an entire week of VBS. And so just a fun fundraiser that we do every year. And there's always consequences for whether the boys win or the girls win. And this year it was decided against my will that if the girls win the offering, that I would have to shave my head. And if the boys win, Tori, our youth director, will have
against
to,
her will.
Against her will, yes, will have to eat a bug. And so we've ordered, yes, yes. So we have ordered a cheddar cheese gigantic tarantula that she'll be, no, I'm just kidding. I think it's like a cricket or something. She'll have to do that if the boys win. So we're going to go ahead and take up that offering, get it out of the way so that the guys can have plenty of time to count it by the time the service is over. Now, if you are one of those that, man, I want to see Pastor Jamie get his head shaved, and that's okay. I just felt that it was my responsibility to show you what the Word of God says concerning such. Okay? So if we could show some verses there. Psalm 105:15, it says, don't touch the head of the Lord's anointed ones. Okay? It's all through Scripture. The Leviticus 21:5, it says, the Lord's anointed shall not make bald spots on their heads. Ezekiel 44:20, it says also, they shall not shave their heads. Numbers 6:5, it says, you must not cut his hair throughout the time of his vow. And so if you want the responsibility of, and those, you know, that innocence on you, that's up to you. You have the free will to do that. I just wanted you to know what God's Word says about shaving the head of your leaders and your elders, okay? So I'm a place that in your hands. Our ushers, if you'll come forward, we'll go ahead and we're going to give you one last chance. I know the girls and boys have been so excited about Tori eating a bug all week long. I believe the boys are a little behind, and so we need some help. We need some help. The boys need lots of help, okay? All right. No, you cannot, Tori. No, I'm sorry. What do you want to say, Tori? Tori has a word. Let me
real quick. Y'all remember, I love y'all's babies. And I have a very weak stomach. Ketchup is not going to cover up the taste of a cricket. And it's a big cricket. So, I went to school with a lot of y'all. Y'all have known me since I was little. I mean, I'm from Sharon. I'm going to need some help. I will even trade off, and I won't make Jamie shave his head. I'll give him my cricket if the girls win. I think that's a fair trade.
Hey, listen, a lot of you, I've baptized your kids. Remember that. Remember that. I've dedicated your babies. Okay? All right. I love all of you. You're my one and only family in this whole world. You got one chance to give. All right. Hey, on a serious note, thank all of you for give. I know some of you have given your kids throughout the week. It does help us fund things. This year, as you know, we're in a very large building project. 100% of all the offering throughout this weekend today goes to our building fund, okay? So you can give as much as you want, knowing that one day your children will be enjoying that facility. Boys love basketball. We'll have two basketball courts over there, okay? Hey, last thing, this is very, very important. If you're giving cash, you make sure that you get one of those envelopes to mark boys or girls, okay? We have to know which way that it goes, and if you're writing a check, it needs to be specified boys or girls. That's the only way we know which one it comes in. The ushers will have some envelopes if you can't find one in front of you in the pews, okay? All right, let's pray, and then we'll begin. We've got an entire show with these kids ahead. Okay, for the kids that do have money, they're welcome to bring theirs to the bucket. The blue is the boys, which is the only bucket that's available this morning. And then there's the white one for the girls, okay? I know some of them was looking forward to coming. That's how we do it throughout the week. But the ushers will be coming down the aisles just like the regular offering. Okay, let's pray. Lord, we love you. We thank you. Use these gifts for the upbuilding of your kingdom. In Jesus' name we ask. Amen.
Amen.
Okay. Ushers, are we done? We done? Okay. Yeah. Is that it? Okay. Thank you so much. All right. Hey, if I can get your attention, we'll begin. We'll begin. All right. We're going to, as you know, of course, this service is a lot different than normal, and so I apologize for the hecticness. And so, Tori, are we ready to begin? All right. I'm going to turn it over to Miss Tori Brooke. She is the our children's director, has put endless hours of effort and work into planning and directing this VBS. And so we're thankful for all our volunteers, but I'm telling you, I'm truly thankful for Tori and the tremendous work that she does. I've seen her at work, ladies and gentlemen. She's dedicated her life to these kids, and I say to her, thank you, and we are blessed at Bethlehem Community Church to have her with us. Will you give her a round of applause?
All right, so we are going to start off our service just like we started off every night of Bible school. After we had a little bit of smack talk about the offering, we went straight into the pledges. So I'm going to get my guys and gals that are holding our flags and our Bibles to come on up. And we're going to start with the American flag. So everybody's going to stand at attention, salute, pledge. Now we're going to do, if you've been to our VBS closing services before, you know we normally jam everybody on stage and then you can't really see anybody, but we get it done all at one time, and we've decided to do things a little different so everybody has a chance to be seen and get a picture. So we are going to start off with our 5th and 6th graders. They're going to come up and show us our first song.
Let's go down to the river. Just see what's going on. Let's go down to the river. To remember what God.
is our third and fourth graders.
Yes.
Our kindergarten class is up next.
Right here. Get over there.
friends, listen to me. We're going to get back on the stage behind our preschoolers. So kindergarten, y'all come up. First and second grade. Where's first and second grade at? Y'all are going to come up this way and get behind kindergarten.
Thank you.
If I can make the whole church clap, it ain't a clap in the heavens, then they clap, that's a clap, clap. All of a sudden glorified, sin mortified. The Holy Spirit will go and word it to them all again. It sound like perfect and dominant. Let the promise sing it loud, but that ain't gonna power sound. All the church, church has been clapping in weak sermons, leaving the weak hurt that was changed by Sunday service. We need discernment, check what you be affirming. Cause the church can be full of members, but empty and conversion.
$16.82. For the boys, your total
was less than that.
Is $2,808. Gathered from, I'm sure, all of you's vehicles and closets. And I mean, we had kids bringing bags this big of coins. It was just amazing. And so anyway, we had a great time. It was a lot of fun. Like I said, all those funds will go to our building fund. And so, Tori, I'm going to do it like you want to. What do you need? Ketchup? Mustard? Honey mustard?
I'm going to need a chocolate ice cream cone, maybe an escort to my car.
We got some bread or something. Okay, we've got three different flavors.
I mean,
they are? They are grasshoppers. Or crickets, right?
They're crickets.
It looks like a big grasshopper to me. We got sour cream and onion.
Wait. I had some kids volunteer to eat this bug for me.
Bacon and cheese and salt and vinegar. Okay? So those are the three. Those are the three.
I need coke and some fresh ranch.
Need something to drink for sure. You need a piece of bread. You want to wrap it up in bread? Cheese?
Yeah, I like cheese.
Hey, here's some water.
I need something with flavor. I'm a little nervous though, so I think I'll break it.
Hey, just for the record, every one of these grasshoppers has 0.67 grams of protein.
Well, there's that.
All right. Do you have a specific flavor, Miss Troy?
Thank you, salt and vinegar.
The salt and vinegar, okay. Salt and vinegar, yes. I would rather you open that up.
I don't think the Lord wants me to do this.
No. Just one. We're not going to make her eat the whole pack.
I mean, you've got the Bible verses. I'm not John the Baptist. I know he ate locusts and honey.
He did.
I'm Tori
Brooks. It was a regular diet. Regular diet for the Israelites.
Now listen, y'all grown-ups, I want you to know I was a good sport all week. I was not even going to make Jeremy shave his head. I was just going to eat it and be done with it, and now I don't know if I can do this. I mean...
To all of you. I appreciate your gift. Hey, real quick, and I'll let you go. Hey, real quick. Hey, our verse, can we get our verse up there? PowerPoint, the verse there for this week. Our key passage for this year's VBS. Of course, the theme was In the Wild. But hey, real quick, this is what God's Word says. Actually, verses 30 through 31. It says, Jesus performed many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not recorded in this book. But these are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that by believing you may have life in his name. Hey, here's what I know. Was there a lot of things Jesus did that we don't find in Scripture? Yes, tons of stuff. I mean, we probably couldn't even record all the things. But it says there were certain things that were recorded so that we believe. Hey, listen to me. Your kids are going to have a litany of stuff to grab their attention, a litany of things that they can go after and offer to them, but don't fail to make sure that they miss out on the things that are most important. It's amazing how us as Christians many times can get so caught up into so many different things that don't mean a hill of beans. There's a ton of stuff that we as Christians can even get caught up in concerning good activities. I've done it before. You can take some good things and use it wrongly. Make sure that you're involving your kids in the things that are most important. Listen, you're going to have to remind yourself over and over and over. Hey, one story, and I'm done. One story. Listen real quick. There was this lady. She had it in her heart to purchase some stained glass windows for her church. The church that she went to didn't have the funds to offer stained glass windows, as you see here in our church. But she was passionate about that. That's what she wanted to do for the Lord. It's what she wanted to do for her church. And so she said, I need to get some measurements. And so she started measuring. She measured the windows by her hands. She was a little old-fashioned, didn't know much about carpentry. And so she measured the windows by her hands, top to bottom, side to side. And she got to calling and searching, and she couldn't find any place that took those kind of measurements. So she went back to her church, and she measured using her arms back and forth. And she did that several times. She used her legs. She even did full body measurements. And every time she would call, every time she would search, she couldn't find anybody that had those types of measurements. And so she kept doing one thing after another. She was passionate about it. She worked endlessly searching and trying to find that. And then after a while, you know what happened? She quit. She gave up. You know why? Because she was using the wrong measurement. Listen. Your kids are gonna have all kinds of things offered to them. Don't let them get to be a teenager, get to be a young adult, and realize that they've been measuring this whole Christian thing wrongly all the while. Don't let them get caught up into the wrong things that measures what success is, that measures what good is, that measures what great is. Because here's the thing. They can be as passionate and as desirable as they want to. But if they have the wrong measurement, they're going to miss out. Because the Christian life is not all about the bells and whistles. Listen, emotion is not enough, parents. Listen to me. This is important. All the bells, all the whistles, all the excitement, that's not enough to carry them. Yes, we want them to have fun in the house of the Lord, and they had plenty this week. We want them to know that they have fun in the house of the Lord, but they can't apply anything that they don't know. And as parents, it's vital that you're involving them in the Word of God, in praying and understanding all those things, because those are the things that measure what success is. Don't let them get caught up into following the world's standards of what they need to do to be great, to be successful, because it will lead them on an endless journey of regret and misery, because it's never enough. And so I encourage you to help them along the way and make it as easy as possible for them to be involved in the things of the Lord. Hey, thank you so much for bringing your kids this week. We had a blast. It's the highlight of our year, and it's come to an end, and it's bittersweet for some of us, but I'm sure many of you are ready to go take a nap. And we will not have evening services. We want to give you that break. Let's close, and let's have a word of prayer, okay? Everybody's heads bowed and eyes closed. No one. Thank you so much for joining in on our services today. If you've received Jesus Christ as your Savior, or you would like prayer, or you'd just like some more information about our church, please email us at the email address at the bottom of your screen. We look forward to hearing from you, and may God bless you, and we hope to see you next week.